Welcome back to General Discharge. I'm Nick Nausea, and today we're going to talk about rucking. Make sure you hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and hit that little bell thing. We told you a little bit about rucking in our How to Make a Pig Egg video. Now we're going to get more into the specifics about how to progress your ruck running from I don't even know what ruck running is to being properly conditioned for rucking at the standard required by your respective special program or selection course. Keep in mind, we're just giving you tricks and tips. We're not creating a specific program or regimen for you to follow. Let's talk about glutes. If you're not experienced with ruck running and you need to start training up on how to ruck run, then you need to find out what boots are authorized in that training course and try to find a similar pair of boots that you will use during training. That might mean if you're a civilian awaiting boot camp or basic, finding something similar to an issued military boot. In your circumstance, I'd say not too similar, because military issued boots are not always the best for your particular foot type. We're going to drop a link in the description for some tips on looking for boots. Now, I'm not going to get too into socks, but I will say they're important. Socks is actually one of the few cases where you can pretty much count on the more expensive they are, the better they perform. If they're a $15, $20 pair of socks, they're probably worth the money, and it's probably not a bad idea to spend that much on a pair of socks. I've also tried merino wool socks that were $12 for a pack of three, and they performed very well. I love them. They just didn't have the durability. They wore out and got holes very quickly, and I had to throw them away. Stay away from cotton. Synthetic materials are going to be the best for your feet, and a wool synthetic blend isn't bad either. In fact, it's really good. A few of your go-to brands are going to be Fox River, Darn Tough, and Fitz. If you're in colder climates or like thicker socks with more cushioning, make sure your boot size accommodates that. Leave some room for that so you're not creating pressure points when you have those thick socks on. Now, finally on to progression. A well-decorated member of the special operations community once told me, just throw some weight on your back and walk. Get comfortable with that. He said the cutoff pace is 15 minutes a mile. That's walking. That's about as simple advice as you can get. To give you some further context, the implied timeline was to do that for once or twice a week for about 6 months with no more than 35 pounds. His theory was to get the body adapted to moving well with weight while minimizing risk of injury or overtraining. In addition, please understand that this advice does not mean that showing up to selection with the expectation that you can casually walk through your timed ruck runs and still meet the standards is a good idea. You likely won't meet the standard with that attitude, because the standard is to exceed the standard. You will still have to push yourself. However, applying that advice in addition to your running, swimming if that applies, calisthenics, and weightlifting, you should be in a good spot. That rucking advice might seem a little low on the volume, but you must also consider the other activities in your training and ensure that you will be getting maximal gains and minimal risk of injury. Now, onto some more advice from an additional resource, the MARSOC Prep Guide. It's free. You can download it on your phone. There's even a free app if you want to follow the full program. But just keep in mind, the app does not have the explanation and advice on ruck run. It just lists and tracks the workouts. Here's your key takeaways from that piece of material. Gear: external frame mountain pack or Alice pack. Frequency: twice a week, once for speed, once for distance. Work your speed runs up to 4 miles and your distance runs up to 12 over a 10-week period. Weight: 45 pounds. My caveat to that: start at 15 and work your way up to 45 pounds. Listen to your body and adjust the weight accordingly, putting a higher emphasis on speed and distance. I saw a guy pass a 12-mile ruck run without realizing he accidentally put 60 pounds instead of 50. Once your body is well adapted to moving with weight, you won't notice a few extra pounds. But don't be stupid. Use the right amount of weight. Pace: 15-minute mile is the average. 13 is competitive. Strategies: mile on, mile off. It's pretty self-explanatory. Run for a mile, walk for a mile. Running the terrain: utilize the downhill and the flat ground to run while walking up hills. Time and distance: you can use a ratio of running 3 minutes, walking for 1 minute, for example. If you don't have a watch for some reason, or you're not allowed to use one during your graded ruck runs, you can always use landmarks instead. I'm gonna run to that bend in the trail, and then from there I pick a landmark that I'll walk to. One more thing to take seriously: you will burn far more calories ruck running than you will just going on a normal run. Hydrate well before, during, and after your ruck run, and consider using electrolyte beverages as well. Keep some snacks in your pocket, something like honey packets and orange or gummy bears are also great. I know it seems weird to think about eating candy during your workout, but anything with simple sugars that can get broken down rapidly by the body will be immediately used for energy if you feel like you're hitting a wall. Ease into your rucking if you're new to it. Coming soon, General Discharge is going to teach y'all more details about avoiding medical emergencies during your training, things like heat stroke, heat exhaustion, hyponatremia, or rhabdomyolysis. We'll also provide y'all with some more guidance on foot care and preventing blisters. In the meantime, let us know in the comments what other topics y'all would like some tricks and tips on. Well, that's all I got for you guys for now. Remember, train hard, train safe, and do you even want to be here? Nausea, out. All your friends are subscribing to General Discharge, and you don't even want to be here.